Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how you can use Gatekeeper in OS X to protect your Mac. So what is Gatekeeper? Gatekeeper is something you'll find in System Preferences, and it's one of the main ways that your Mac protects you from malware. So if you go into System Preferences and you search for Gatekeeper, you'll see it points to Security and Privacy. When you go to Security and Privacy, you won't find anything called Gatekeeper there. It's a little confusing because Apple took away the name but not the functionality in El Capitan. Before that, you would see Gatekeeper as one of the options up here, or it would be labeled down here. But this is the functionality right here. Allow apps downloaded from. And it gives you three options. In order to access those three options, you need to unlock the panel with your password. Now you can switch between three options here. To allow apps only from the Mac App Store, allow them from the Mac App Store, but also from identified developers or from anywhere, basically turning Gatekeeper off. So what do these do? Well, this one's pretty obvious. You can only download software from the Mac App Store, but that's not exactly true. Gatekeeper will prevent you from easily installing software that's not from the Mac App Store, but you can still install any software on your Mac, and I'll show you how that works. The second level allows you to download software from other websites and install it as long as that software has been signed by the developer with the certificate that they got from Apple. In other words, Apple has a relationship with the developer and there's some identification of where that software comes from. Now this isn't a guarantee that the software won't contain anything bad, but it is a guarantee that Apple can identify the software easily. So, for instance, if a developer does something bad, Apple can revoke their certificate and not allow them to publish signed software anymore. But more likely, what this is going to be used for is if some piece of software gets on your computer and maybe on many Macs that has some malware, Apple can shut that down. They can update the security software in OS X, and that security software is updated all the time online. Your version of Mac OS X is always calling into Apple, finding out the latest security updates. And it can shut down that app, maybe even before you know anything is wrong. So this can protect you from a case where, say, a developer itself is hacked and then unknowingly distributes software that has some malware in it. And this has happened recently where a legitimate developer with a signed piece of software has distributed something with some malware in it, and what happened was they were hacked and somebody else put that malware in their software. It only affected a very tiny number of people that used a certain BitTorrent client and downloaded it in a certain way, so it's nothing that probably you need to worry about at all, and the situation's been taken care of because Apple was able to revoke that signature so that identified developer was able to then be turned off and the legitimate developer actually got a new identifier to use for future software. Anywhere though, what's going to happen then, it's even going to give you a warning here, just allows you to install anything from anywhere. There's really no reason for anybody to have this turned on. Maybe if you're a software reviewer who writes reviews and you're installing stuff many times a day, or you're a tester installing things many times a day. But even then, it's so easy to allow Gatekeeper to install something, even if you're on one of these higher settings, that there's really no excuse to have this turned on. I recommend everybody keep their setting on Mac App Store only, and I'm going to keep it there now, and I'm going to show you how you can still download software from a trusted developer. So just as an example, I've gone to the Smith Micro Software site. They've been around for decades and they're a trusted developer, and they have the Stuffit expander tool, which will allow you to expand .sit files if you have any of those lying around from a long time ago. And I'm going to download their free tool here, and it'll go into the downloads folder. I'm going to hide Safari and go into my downloads folder. I'm going to click on the disk image there, and it's going to expand the disk image. So now I have this. This is the disk image here, and what I need to do in order to use this is I can just run it from here, or I can put it into my applications folder. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to drag and drop this into my applications folder. So now I've added it in there, and now I'm going to go ahead and run it and see what happens, because I didn't download this from the Mac App Store, and yet I have my Gatekeeper settings set to Mac App Store only. Okay, so I'm going to double click on the app, and it's going to give me a warning, can't open it up because my security preference is only on installation of apps from the Mac App Store. I'm going to hit OK, and now how do I get around that? Well, I could go back into System Preferences here and basically upgrade my security level, or downgrade it to another thing, and then it will then allow me to run it. But I can also use this Open Anyway button. Notice how it knows the last app I tried to open that it blocked, and it will allow me to open it anyway. But what Open Anyway does is it only bumps the level up one amount. So this is an app that not only is not from the Mac App Store, but isn't signed by an identified developer because it's an old app. So if I say Open Anyway, it's still not going to work. It's still going to say it can't do it because it actually needs to bump all the way up to the Anywhere thing, because it's not only is it not from the Mac App Store, but it's not from identified developers. If I had my setting here, then I can hit Open Anyway, and even though it's not from an identified developer, it will bump it up to the Anywhere level, and it will ask me if I'm sure I want to open it. I say yes, and it opens. And you can see the little icon here for me to drop stuff on. So to summarize, for most Mac users, you want to have it just set to Mac App Store, and then only download apps from the Mac App Store or from developers you really trust. Use the Open Anyway button if you decide to download something else. And make sure you trust those developers. For instance, you can download Office from Microsoft. You can download the Adobe software. You can download from other developers you really trust, you really know, and you're sure you're at their actual website, not downloading it from some other place. Now, if you want to do that, then you want to set it here if you're going to do that often. But I would just keep it here and then use that Open Anyway button to open that software that's signed by developers. I don't think anybody should ever have their setting to Anywhere. If you're somebody that downloads lots of software from third parties that's not in the Mac App Store, use the middle setting. Use the Open Anyway button after you're sure that you trust the software, and give yourself that one extra step to prevent you from accidentally opening something that maybe you should have thought twice about.